Yes, this is Sumuga, Massachusetts. Today's date is December 10th, 2021. And we are back at the State Department. As always, not just for the ongoing summit for democracy, but it's a routine for the Ugandan community in the US that we come here and we represent 45 million Ugandans and other fellow Ugandans that that cannot make it to where we are right now. So we are representing you, but I would have to remind you that as you're in your homes, in your workplaces, please don't forget to do the needful, tweet, and make sure to share these messages. Don't forget to hashtag and tag the rightful offices, organizations, representatives, and ambassadors. Let's raise our voices, and together we shall have a free Uganda. This is a struggle that entails not only demonstrations, it entails writing, calling, tweeting, and speaking up. I want to thank everyone that has that is doing whatever small or minor thing it is that is pushing this revolution of realizing Uganda's victory and getting freedom for all our political prisoners, the abducted, the kidnapped, and those that were imprisoned. That's why we do what we do on a daily. Yesterday and today, there is a summit for democracy that was hosted by the United States. Today is the final day of this summit, and the main theme is democracy in the world. The theme statement for this this summit is democracy is does not come by accident, does not happen by accident. It comes when you fight for it, you strengthen it, you renew it, and defend it. Now, that was a very powerful indirect message from the main host of this summit, President Biden. And we are also here to put our voice to that and remind Mr. President Biden that we cannot fight for democracy in Africa. We cannot defend democracy in Africa. We cannot strengthen democracy in Africa. And we also cannot renew democracy in Africa if we are fighting the world's superpower, the United States of America. The dictators, the slave masters and terrorists that are running nations in Africa, killing civilians and citizens of Africa, are being funded by the same government, by the same administration of President Joe Biden. So if we really have to work towards renewing, strengthening, and fighting for our democracy in Africa, then we need full accountability from the funders and all other development partners of the African continent. Only then we can have full democracy and meaningful democracy. And we are also saying we need democracy, not arms. Ladies and gentlemen, let's not forget to hashtag democracy, not arms. People power.
Our power.
People power. NUP.
Everywhere.
And everywhere.
NUP.